Hello everyone. Today we will be going over how to work the iNaturalist app and how to input and view observations. iNaturalist is an app that helps you identify plants and animals around you. It is a citizen science project where an online social network of naturalists, citizen scientists, and biologists identify and share their own observations, as well as comment on and discuss other people's observations. It's built on the concept of mapping and sharing observations of biodiversity across the globe. iNaturalist may be accessed via its website or from its mobile applications. So you're going to start by downloading the app onto your phone. It's free and all you need is an email to create an account. So this is what it looks like. And when you open it up, you can either create your account using an email or log into an existing one. If you're already logged in, then the app will log you in as soon as you open it. You'll see at the very bottom bar, there is your menu with five options that say Explore, Activity, Observe, Me, and More. So we're going to start with the Maps option. Here you can see your location. The blue round dot is where you are on the map. You can also see all the observations made by people around you. So if you look at the very top of your screen, right above the map, you're going to see three icons. The first one shows the map view. If you click on the one beside it, that shows the gallery view. And the one beside that shows you the species in a list view. So we're going to go back to the map view, which is the very first one. So you can see on your map observations around you. The green points are for plants, the blue is for animals, the pink is for mushrooms, and the red is for insects. So when you click an observation, you can see who uploaded it and when. You'll also see more information on the observation, such as the photos that they've uploaded, more on the species that they've observed, and the option to comment, or the option to suggest another identification. If you suggest a new ID, you can either enter the comment as the same species, supporting the user's identification, or if you think it's something different, you can suggest something new. Next, we're going to look at the Activity tab. This shows you the interactions with fellow iNaturalists. So if someone comments on your observation, it will show up here. Now we are going to look at the Observe tab. When you click this, it will open up your camera. So if you're in the field, you can take a picture of something that you want to observe, or you can choose to upload one from your photo library. So here I'm going to be uploading one from my gallery. So I'm going to press the bottom right photo icon and choose the pictures that I want to select for my ID. When selecting or taking photo observations, take the time to consider a few key factors about the picture that you're going to use. Make sure that the quality is good. If your photo quality is low or it's blurry, it will make it hard to accurately ID it. Remember that they are being uploaded onto a shared database and other people are going to want to see it and ID it. If you can, get a clear shot from multiple angles to show off all important or distinct features of the thing that you are identifying to ensure a more accurate identification. For trees, that would be showing the leaf arrangement and shape. Are the leaves in an opposite arrangement? Are they alternate? Are the leaves toothed or lobed? Make sure to take a picture if it has cones, buds, flowers, or catkins. You're also going to want to show what the bark looks like. For plants, you want to show the flower or fruit if there is one. If you're showing a flower, make sure to include all flower parts. Make sure to also include the leaf shape and the arrangement. Animals sometimes can be trickier because they move and maybe you can't get a clear shot, but try your best to show distinct markings, colors, and size of the animal. So once you've chosen your photos, you can click the next button and it will bring you to this page. So at the very top, you'll see the photos that you've chosen. And then we can scroll to the very bottom where it says projects. You can click that. If you want to add your observation to a project, you can. If you don't have a project to add it to, that's fine. You don't need to select one. You can just go back. The next one is captive or cultivated. So if what you observed was captive, or maybe it's something you cultivated in your own backyard, then make sure to indicate that it was. If it's not, then just select no and done. The one above that, called geoprivacy, is a very important one because this is the option to share the location of your observation, and everyone who has the app will be able to see this exact location. So if you have an at-risk or endangered species and you want to protect it, especially if it's vulnerable to poaching or over-harvesting, for example, a wood turtle or wild ginseng, make sure you turn this location onto private, so there will be no location for the observation, or obscured. It just won't show the exact location, but will give a general area of where it was found. If it's a very common plant, then that's okay. You can just click open. Above that is the location. So this is the location that your observation was taken. You can change this location if you want to. And then above that is the date. So make sure that this is the date that the photo was taken. Above that, you have the option to add any notes if you want to. And then above that, it will say suggestions or what do you see. So click this tab. If you know what your species is, you can look it up into the search bar. If not, the app will give you some suggestions. So sometimes there will be one strong match to what the photo is. And then underneath it, there's around 10 other suggestions that are visually similar. Make sure that you're only identifying your observation down to the taxonomic level that you are sure of. If you're unsure and you can only ID it down to the genus, that's okay. You can still input that and upload that. And maybe your iNaturalist community will comment later on after you've posted to help you out with some suggestions as to what it is. So you can go through the suggestions. Just because one's higher than the other doesn't mean that it's right. It's just a suggestion. Again, these are suggestions. They are not always right. So make sure you are actually looking at them before you select one. So you can click the I button right beside the suggestion that's circled in a little blue icon. That will give you some more information on the suggestion that it's giving you. So at the top, you can scroll through the photos and you can compare it to your photos to see if they're similar. Right below it, there's a little blurb that will give you more information on the species. And then a map where it has been observed in the app. So if you think this is the correct one, you can select it. And then once you click share, it will upload it. And then you've made your first observation. Now that you've uploaded your first observation, we can move over to the tab next to observations that's called me. This is where you'll see all the posts that you've made, as well as other people's comments. You will notice a comment bubble on the right. This shows how many comments have been made on your post. If the comment bubble is gray, it means you've already read them. And if the comment bubble is red, it means you have comments you have not yet seen. So you can click on your post, and then you can click on the little comment button to see what other people have commented. Now we're going to go to the final tab. So right to the right of where the V tab is, it will say more with three dots. This is where you can see projects. So you can click projects. You can see projects that you've already joined. You can click the featured to see a list of projects, or you can click the nearby to see a list of projects that are close to you. And that is the iNaturalist app tutorial. Thank you.